Counting documents in Firestore can be tricky. Naïve solutions like fetching all documents just to count them can be slow and expensive, especially at scale. This video will walk you through the best way to count documents effectively in SwiftUI projects, step by step using Firestore aggregation queries and real-time updates to keep your apps fast and responsive. And also check out my super sale. I bundled all of my products plus SwiftUI Camp. The link is down in the description later about this in the video. Now, today I'm going to go further on Firestore CRUD operations, and we are going to count the documents. Now, one way of doing this is basically fetching the documents that we want to count and then count it on the client side, but that is much too expensive, you know, price-wise and also on bandwidth-wise. That's not the way of doing this. There is a better way, and that is on the query, there is a count, and this is what we are going to add on today. We are going to use Firestore collection that is from the previous episodes, and I'm also building on the previous episodes. Go ahead and check out the link in the description for the full tutorial. What you need to know is that we are fetching some cards, and I'm fetching here all the cards, and what I want to do is just maybe right over here under the navigation title, I just want to display how many cards there are entirely in my collection. Okay, so first of all, to make this work, we need to upgrade from Firestore Collection 1.0.9, that is the previous version of Firestore Collection that I implemented, to 2.0.1, I believe, but above 2.0.0. And also, in the meantime, I just added some convenience API initializers for better fetching. Okay, so let's just do that. Let's start by making sure that we are on up to next major version, Firestore Collection 2.0.0. And now it should fetch it. Let's just open this up and let's just wait for it. Yes, 2.0.1. Okay, so now we are going to have some errors. Let's build and run, or just build, to see all of the errors that I'm just going to fix with the new API. And you will see it's much, much simpler. So first of all, it says we don't have this fetch ID with user ID. This is when we are fetching only one document. So now, instead of that, we just have one fetch universal API call. And then on the type, we are just going to have one. And then the ID will be the user ID. Pretty straightforward, right? So let's hit Command B. So there are, I believe, four more issues right over here. So cards collection fetch all with some predicates. So next up is this fetch all, which is kind of confusing because we are not fetching all of our documents if we add on extra predicates, not just ordering by the created at time. So I'm just going to comment this out and type it out with the new API. So try await cards collection dot fetch, and then on the type you want to go for more, not just one, but more. Okay, and then on the predicates, let's just copy our predicate array in there. Okay, and that should be also, yeah, let's just build and run and see the next one. iOS developers, this is your golden ticket. I'm bundling all my SwiftUI products into one epic super sale, a massive 91% off. And to make it even better, I'm adding SwiftUI Camp, my 4-week live bootcamp where you'll become an expert SwiftUI developer. Total value, $2,280. But for a limited time, you get everything for just $199. Don't miss out, SwiftUI Camp starts on March the 3rd, right after the sale ends. Grab this insane deal now, link is in the description. There we go. This is for the first. So this is when we are fetching the first three elements created at. Again, it's a new API. And by the way, all of this is returning a fetch collection state. Go ahead and check out the previous episode to learn more about this. I'm not going to use this at the moment. Try await and then cards collection dot fetch. There you go. As you can see, it is returning a fetched collection state, either empty or fetching. Take a look at that in the previous episode. And then we want to go for the type, not first. There it is, the first. first, and then we have some options. Remember, when we are fetching in a paginated manner, we want to add in our limit and the ordered by, and either it's increasing or decreasing, decreasing or increasing. So here we have this paginated fetch option. So we just hit dot in it, and I'm going to hit return. For the limit, we are going to have free ordered by, copy it out so I don't have any typos. And then optionally, you could just also add, let me just see, what's the name of it? Yes, descending. So default value is true. If you want to set this to false, then you can add that too. True is really great for us. And no extra predicates. Now, we don't need any extra predicates here. You could add if you wanted to. The same goes for the fetch next, but it's not fetch first, but fetch next. I'm just going to copy it out and paste it in there, and then next. And the same options and predicates will apply. Let's hit Command B. Now it all should work. And we are ready to go and add in our count functionality. What are we going to do? Well, we are going to go to the All Cards view. And remember, I just want the count right over here. All Cards, and then just add it right over here. Now, how would that be? Well, in 2.0.0, I included a new count property onto the cards collection. So cards collection dot, and there is this count. It is optional because, you know, maybe you are not counting anything, or if there is an error when we are fetching, then it's just going to return nil. It's optional. I want to add this. Well, if it's not nil, so let's just say if it's not nil, then we are going to nil. It's fine. I'm not going to add anything right over here. Or let's just go with not available, just like that. And then string cards collection count, that should be fine, but I prefer string interpolation. So let's just go like this. And you can easily bang it out, no worries, because we are checking against the nil value on the count. So that's how we are going to display it. Now, how are we actually going to fetch it? Well, we are going to go on the onAppear, fetch all cards. And right over here, let's just scroll down and let's create a new function, func, and fetch count. It will be an asynchronous throwing function. Therefore, I'm just copying this task and do catch out. And then I go try await. There we go, try await. Cards collection. Cards collection dot. And now with the newly introduced fetch API, we could just go the type to be count and then the predicates. Now, on the predicate, let's just scroll up. We have this ordered by, or you could just leave it out if you want to. I'm just going to go without for now, and that should fetch all of the count, so all the documents in this collection. Of course, if you want to, you may add anything, you know, just filter your count. Okay, that's how we are fetching it. Also, we need to fetch, you know, just use this when we are appearing. So let's just scroll up on appear. After we fetch our cards, we are going to fetch the count. And also, we are going to add it when we are creating a card. So it's just going to update the value. And also when we are deleting, there we go, delete the card. And then right over here, fetch count. Did I add those two parentheses? Yes. Okay, so let's test this out. Let's build and run and select our all cards view. Great, now let's select all the cards. Currently it was not available, but you can just leave it out as an empty string or whatever. And then we have 7 cards. And indeed, if we count them all, they are 7. Let's add a new one. There we go. Well, after the fetch all cards. And as you can see, it's basically not updating. We're going to take care of that in just a second. Let's just see if we are, let's build and run and see that actually there are 8 documents in the collection. And then let's just go to all cards. There we go, 8. Now let's delete one, just like that. And that basically updates, but what about when we are creating it? Well, it turns out that we just need to wait a little bit. So after we are fetching all the cards then we are creating, I just want to wait for a second. So task, try await, task dot sleep for 1 second. Okay, now let's build and run. Let's just see, asynchronous. Yeah, we do need to add then a task right over here. And great. Let's build and run. And let's see it. Basically, while it is waiting for the server to be updated, our client is already being updated. Therefore, we just need to wait a few more seconds so we can fetch the new counts. So let's just go under all cards. It is 7. Let's just click on the plus button. And after 1 second, it just updated nicely, which is a great user experience. This is how you should definitely fetch the counts of your documents. It's just one fetch on the database. It's really, really nice. And in the next video, I'm going to talk about incrementing and decrementing values, property values in our documents. And if you'd like these types of videos, go ahead and also check out my super sale. The link is down in the description.